the stories so far.
You are now both prisoners of the Robotol Empire.
You're not just going to let them take us, are you, Doctor?
I don't think we have much choice, Mrs. Wibbsey.
Oh, look, Doctor. He's just a toddler.
Alex has been critically ill for weeks.
Indeed, the Tsar and Tsarina's son and heir is a cyborg.
You mean you're all robots? I can't take it in. You're so lifelike for a mechanical man.
Alex's heart is not the only thing which ticks inside his savage breast. Hidden beneath it, a Shkistare egg.
You realize you're in league with one of the most hideously fiendish races in the cosmos. You must keep it out of the clutches. And whatever you do, it must never hatch.
It's like one of those Fabergé things. It's beautiful.
And deadly, Bulin. I want you to take charge of it for now.
This place is about to go up.
We've only one hope. The wormhole transport.
I'm sorry, Doctor, but no. I'll take my chances in the shuttle with Alex.
I'm going to send Bulin's shuttle to Earth, Hexford, to be precise.
Doctor Who, Serpent Crest, The Broken Crown by Paul Magrs, starring Tom Baker and Susan Jameson.
Imagine living in a house with nowhere to hide, where the people who were supposed to look after you just made your life a misery and didn't leave you in peace for a moment. Imagine if the folk you were trying to get away from always came looking for you. If you imagine those things, you imagine me.
There you are, skulking away in the library. You shouldn't be in here unsupervised. There are things in this library you aren't supposed to see.
I know.
Your guardian makes these rules in order to protect you, Andrew. The rector knows best.
I know that.
What's this you're reading?
It's nothing. It's just...
The Arabian Nights.
But I...
You know, child, that this is one of the banned books in this house.
I don't see why. It's harmless.
Books as colourful as this will overstimulate your imagination. That is not good for you.
Let me have it back, please.
Certainly not. You'll come with me. Your guardian is waiting for you. He must hear of this.
I watched the wicked old woman climb the library steps to put my book back on the topmost shelf, too high for me to ever reach again. Part of me longed to push her off those steps while she stretched and to send her spinning to the floor. Perhaps I could break the old monster's crooked back. But instead, I merely stood there, feeling lost and hopeless. My mind still spinning with the glorious, magical tales of the Arabian Nights. She was right about one thing, my nursemaid. Tales of this sort, fairy tales and fables, did something to my imagination. They lifted me out of that dark and dreary world in which I found myself living. They made me forget I was a powerless orphan of 13, trapped in the rectory in a village called Hexford, deep in the English countryside. I was at the mercy of these terrible creatures, the rector and the nursemaid, who watched my every move. And not even my imagination was free.
Come away from that window, Master Andrew.
Why?
Because people don't want to see your face looking out at them.
No one can see me. There's hardly anyone around. Just two strangers wandering the village. They didn't even notice me watching them.
Nevertheless, your guardian won't want to hear about you pressing yourself against the windows, looking like a prisoner.
He doesn't like me to do anything.
What was that, young man?
The rector. He'd be happier if he could just shove me away in a broom cupboard and never hear from me again.
What nonsense. Now come and finish your schoolwork for Mr. Bewley.
Please, can I go out? Sally and Jake said they'd wait for me.
You're going nowhere. Looks to me as if a storm's brewing.
But they'll be waiting for me.
Those two should be in the schoolhouse. But I dare say their mother and father are drinking themselves stupid in the White Hart again, too oiled to notice.
I want to see them. They're my friends.
Attend to your algebra, Master Andrew, and don't blub.
Mrs. Audley? Andrew? What's all this? I could hear you both arguing all the way back up the hallway.
It's nothing. The child is testy this afternoon, Mr. Bewley, that is all.
I can't do anything. I can't read the books I want. I can't go outside when I want.
It's all for your own good.
Is it? Or do you just enjoy making up stupid rules?
Why, you little brat!
Mrs. Audley, don't let yourself become aerated.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.